Hi everyone, how are you today? Welcome back. And if you are new here, welcome to my channel, where you can learn the real world coding experience. And this is Hong, the coding expert. If you want to pass any coding exam to start your coding career, or if you are already holding a coding credential, working in the field, and want to learn more in order to advance your coding profession, then you are in the right place. I can't believe how fast time flies. In just a few more weeks, the summer will be gone, the kids will go back to school, and many of us will be back to our busy life as we all do. So you should not wait for the perfect time to start learning and preparing for the exam. I really like the Nike slogan, "Just do it." Some people dream of success, while other people get up early every morning and stay up late at night to open their books, practice, and learn. So it is no surprise they are the one who usually pass the exam. Many of you who just recently passed the exam and sharing your good news with me, and all I have to say is, congratulations again, and your learning journey doesn't end here. It's just a beginning of a new path, better and brighter. Everything is possible when you believe in yourself. I wish you all the best. Today's topic is CBC, COC, CCS, and CCS-P exam prep in 2021, the endocrine system. You will have a chance to code endocrine system surgeries and other procedures that you need to know for the exam and also for work. Alright, without further ado, let's get started. Question number 1. Where are the parathyroid glands located? A. Brain. B. In the neck behind the thyroid. C. On top of each kidney. Or D. Abdomen. What is the correct answer to this question? I give you 15 seconds. Your time starts now. If you pick B, in the neck behind the thyroid, that's great. You know the anatomy, good for you. The parathyroid is located behind the thyroid glands at the front of the neck. There are 4 glands, a superior pair and inferior pair. Superior means above and inferior means below. What do parathyroid glands do? The sole purpose of the parathyroid glands is to control the calcium levels in our blood, in our bones, and throughout our body. Parathyroid glands regulate the calcium by producing a hormone called parathyroid hormone, PTH. Calcium is the most important element in our bodies. We use it to control many organ systems. So calcium is regulated more carefully than any other element. In fact, calcium is the only element with its own regulatory system, the parathyroid glands. Question number 2. The thymus gland plays a role in which of the following? A. Digestion. B. Immune defenses. C. Insulin production. Or D. Sexual and reproductive functions. What is the correct answer to this question? I'll give you 15 seconds. Your time starts now. If you pick B, immune defenses, that's great, you are on the right track now. The thymus gland is in the chest, between the lungs, and behind the breastbone, sternum. It is just in front of, and above the heart. The thymus makes white blood cells called T lymphocytes, also called T cells. These are an important part of the body's immune system, which help us to fight infection. Question number 3. A goiter is an enlargement of what gland? A. Pituitary, B. Parathyroid, C. Thymus, or D. Thyroid. What is the correct answer to this question? I give you 15 seconds. Your time starts now. If you pick D, thyroid, you are exactly right. Good for you. This is normal thyroid, and this is an enlarged thyroid or goiter. A goiter is described as an abnormal enlargement of the thyroid gland, commonly caused by a deficiency of dietary iodine, along with a lump or swelling in your neck. The symptoms of goiter include a hoarse voice, tightness in your throat, swollen neck veins, coughing, and trouble breathing or swallowing. Question number 4. Low blood sugar is called A. Hyperglycemia, B. Hypoglycemia, C. Hyperparathyroidism, or D. Thyroiditis. I'll give you 15 seconds. Your time starts now. If you pick B, hypoglycemia, that's it. I know you can do it. Hypo means under or below normal. Glycemia means glucose or blood sugar. So hypoglycemia is a low blood glucose or sugar level. This is the gallbladder. This is the common bile duct. This is the duodenum. This is the pancreas. And this is the pancreatic duct. The most important hormone that the pancreas produces is insulin. Its role is to lower glucose level in the bloodstream and promote the storage of glucose in fat, muscle, liver, and other body tissues. Question number 5. What distinguish type 1 diabetes from type 2? A. Insulin injections are always required. B. Age of patient. C. Glucose blood level. Or D. Hypoglycemia. What is the correct answer to this question? I give you 15 seconds. Your time starts now. If you pick A, insulin injections are always required, right on, you haven't missed a thing. Both types of diabetes are chronic disease that affect the way your body regulates blood sugar or glucose. Glucose is the fuel that feeds your body cells, but to enter your cell, it needs a key, and insulin is the key. People with type 2 diabetes don't respond to insulin as well as they should, and later in the disease, often don't make enough insulin. You can think of it as having a broken key. People with type 1 diabetes don't produce insulin. You can think of it as not having the key. Type 1 diabetes requires insulin injection to survive. Question number 6. Hypoparathyroidism is due to an abnormality. Low amount of what hormone? A. Follicle stimulating hormone, FSH, B. Parathyroid hormone, PTH. C. Growth hormone, GH. Or D. Thyrotropin, TSH. What is the correct answer to this question? I give you 15 seconds. The time starts now. If you pick B, parathyroid hormone, PTH, that's great. You are really learning a lot today. Good for you. Parathyroidism is a condition in which one or more of the parathyroid glands secretes an abnormally low amount of the parathyroid hormone, PTH. We already know the follicle-stimulating hormone, FSH, from the previous video. It is the hormone involved in the regulation of the male and female reproductive system. Growth hormone, or human growth hormone, GH, is produced by your pituitary gland. Thyroid-stimulating hormone, TSH, also known as thyrotropin or thyrotrophin, is a hormone that controls the way all the hormones function. When released by the pituitary gland, it stimulates the production of more thyroid hormone. Question number 7. What is the correct CBD code to use for this procedure? Percutaneous needle biopsy of thyroid gland. I put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CBD book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, if you look under the main term, needle biopsy, thyroid gland, it will give you just one code, 60100. Your next step is to double-check this code in the tabular list and hear what you get. 60100, biopsy thyroid. Percutaneous core needle. Now, I want you to pay attention to the note under this code 6011. And it states that if image guidance is performed, see 76942, 77002, 77012, and 77021. So basically, if the biopsy is performed under ultrasound guidance, fluoroscopic guidance, CT or MRI guidance, then you have to report one of these codes in addition to 60100, but it's not mentioned a document in this question. So the correct answer to this question is 60100. Question number 8. What is the correct CBD code to use for the procedure? Right total, thyroid lobectomy. I put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CBD book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CBT book, If you look under the main term, thyroidectomy partial, it will give you a call range 60210 to 60225. Your next step is to check these available calls in the tablet list, and you find that 60220 total thyroid lobectomy unilateral with or without imasectomy, and this is the right call to use because it describes a unilateral right side complete lobectomy. That said, the correct answer to this question is 60220. Question number 9. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? Thyroidectomy for thyroid carcinoma with radical neck dissection. I put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CBT book, if you look under the main term, thyroidectomy, total, for malignancy, radical neck dissection, it will give you just one code, 60254. Your next step is to review this code in the tablet list, and because 60254 is an identical, so I will show you its pairing code. 60252, thyroidectomy total or subtotal for malignancy with limited neck dissection. 60254, this is an identical, so it includes all the information from the code above. 60252, which is the pairing code, except 60254 performed with radical neck dissection. Based on the question, thyroidectomy for thyroid carcinoma with radical neck dissection. So, 60254 is the right code to use. Having said that, the correct answer to this question is 60254. Question number 10. What is the correct CPT code to use for the procedure? Parathyroidectomy with mediastinal exploration. As you just learned from the very first slide is that the parathyroid is located next to the thyroid gland lobes in the neck. There are four glands, a superior pair and inferior pair. These glands help your body control the calcium level in the blood. And parathyroidectomy is surgery to remove the parathyroid glands or parathyroid tumors. I put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CBT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CBT book, if you look under the main term, parathyroidectomy, it gives you a call range 60500 to 60505. Your next step is to check these available codes in the tablet list. And because 60505 is an identical, so I'll show you its pairing code. 60500 parathyroidectomy or aspiration of parathyroid. 60505, this is unidentical, so it includes all information from the coverable. 60500, which is the parent code, except 60505 is performed with mediastinal exploration. And this is the right code to use for this procedure because mediastinal exploration is documented in the question. Having said that, the correct answer to this question is 60505. Just a friendly reminder that if you enjoy what you have learned so far and appreciate my time spent for this video, then you could please pause the video, click the like, subscribe, and share buttons below now to support my channel, and that'd be great. You are the reason that I continue working hard on these lessons. I really want you to do well on the exam and to have more confidence at work. Your comment about my videos and your sharing the good news right after passing the exam really inspire me and make me want to do more. Thank you so much for your support. And we should move on to the next question. Question number 11. What is the correct CPD code to use for the procedure? Exploration and biopsies of adrenal glands, transabdominal. Adrenal glands, also known as subarachnoid glands, are small, triangular-shaped glands located on top of both kidneys. Adrenal glands produce hormones that help regulate your metabolism, immune system, blood pressure, respond to stress, and other essential functions. An adrenal glands biopsy is a procedure used to check for a mass, cyst, or other problems. I put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, if you look under the main term biopsy adrenal gland, it gives you a code range 60540 to 60545 and 60650. Your next step is to check these available codes in the tabular list and hear what you got. 60540. Adrenalectomy, partial or complete, or exploration of adrenal gland with or without biopsy, transabdominal, lumbar or dorsal, separate procedure. 60550, laparoscopy, surgical with adrenalectomy, partial or complete, or exploration of adrenal gland with or without biopsy, transabdominal, lumbar or dorsal. Based on the question on exploration and biopsy adrenal glands are performed transabdominal openly and not laparoscopically, so 60540 is the right code to use for this surgical procedure. That said, the correct answer to the question is 60540. Remember, this type of coding exercise will not only help you familiar with the surgery or procedure that you don't code them every day, but it also assists you in selecting the main terms or keywords in order to look them up in your CPT book correctly. Question number 12. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? Excision of carotid body tumor and carotid artery. A carotid body tumor, also called a chemodectoma or paraganglioma, is a growth on the side of your neck in the area where the carotid artery splits off into smaller blood vessels that carry blood to your brain. I put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, if you look under the main term, excision, carotid body, tumor, it gives you a code range 60600 to 60605. Your next step is to check these available codes in the tabular list, and because 60605 is an identical, so I'll show you its pairing code. 60600 excision of carotid body tumor without excision of carotid artery. 60605, this is an identical, so it includes all the information from the code above 60600, which is the pairing code, except 60605 is also performed with excision of carotid artery. And this is the right code to use for this procedure because the question does mention the excision of carotid artery in addition to the carotid body tumor. Having said that, the correct answer to this question is 60605. Before we tackle this case, it is very similar to what you see on the CBC coding exam. It is a multiple choice question. And if you watch my video series, CBC Exam Prep, then you should know my backwards approach. Instead of reading the procedure report first, which you don't have enough time during the exam, and also, you may or may not have a clue what you are reading or what surgery or procedure that they are doing if you are not a coder or never coded this type of surgery or procedure before. My backward approach is to analyze the answer first, and I am the only one who tackle coding exam this way. Follow my tips and strategy. B and D have the same code, 49652, so they are in the same group. A and C have different codes, 49560 and 49653, so they are in separate groups. Now you know there are three codes that you need to look up in your CPT book. 49560, 49652, and 49653. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already looked them up in your CBT book and hear what you find. 49560, repair initial incisional or ventral hernia reducible. 49652, laparoscopy, surgical, repair, ventral, umbilical, spigelian or epigastric hernia include mesh insertion when performed reducible. 49653, this is an identical, so it includes all the information from the cover ball 49652, which is the pairing code, except 49653 is for incarcerated or strangulated. It happens when herniated tissue becomes trapped and cannot easily be moved back into place. Follow my tips and strategy. You highlight the main difference between each CPT code, and when you're done, you should have an idea what your focus should be when you read the procedure report. You can tell in this case, the first code, 49560, is for an open ventral hernia repair versus 4-9-6-5-2 and 4-9-6-5-P are for laparoscopic ventral hernia repair. So your focus is to find out how the procedure is performed, either open or laparoscopic procedure. Let's read it and find out. A 60-year-old female who has a history of symptomatic ventral hernia was advised to undergo laparoscopic evaluation and repair. An incision was made in the epigastrium and dissection was carried out to the subcutaneous tissue. 2 5mm trocars were placed and the laparoscope was inserted. Based on what I just highlighted, this patient presented with a symptomatic ventral hernia and a laparoscopic ventral hernia repair was performed. So, 4-9-5-6-0 does not apply because this code is for open procedure, not laparoscopic procedure. That said, we can eliminate A from here. B, C, D are still remain, and the only difference between 4-9-6-5-2 and 4-9-6-5-3 is that 4-5-6-9-3 is for incisionated or strangulated hernia, which is not documented in the procedure report. So 4-9-6-5-3 does not apply. That said, we also can eliminate C from here. B and D still remain, and the only difference between them is that D has 4-9-5-6-A, which B doesn't have. So please pause the video, open your CPT book and look up this code 4-9-5-6-A now. Assuming you already look it up in your CPT book and hear what you get. 4-9-5-6-A, implantation of mesh or other prosthesis for open incisional or ventral hernia repair. The plus sign indicate that this is an add-on code, so it must be reported in conjunction with an appropriate primary procedure code. This code is for implantation of mesh or other prosthesis for open incisional or ventral hernia repair. So we cannot use this code for two reasons. First, 4-9-6-5-2 already include mesh insertion. Second, this code 4-9-5-6-A can only be used with open ventral hernia repair and not for a laparoscopic ventral procedure. That said, the correct answer to this case is B, 4-9-6-5-2. Question number 14. Before we tackle this case, again, you should know my backwards approach. Instead of reading the procedure report first, which you don't have enough time during the exam, and if you had to read a 1 or 2 page procedure report with so many technical terms that you don't even know, then you will become more nervous and panicked, and as a result, you lose your focus during the exam. My backward approach is to analyze the answer first and then read the procedure after. This technique will give you an idea what procedure is performed by looking at the CPT code description. And I am the only one who tackle coding exam this way. Follow my tips and strategy. A, B, C, and D all have different codes. 65777A, 65779, 65771, and 65785. So they are in 4 separate groups. Now you know, if there are 3 separate groups, then there are 3 codes that you need to look it up. And if there are 4 separate groups, then there are 4 codes that you need to look it up. In this case, there are 4 separate groups, so there are 4 codes that you need to look up in your CPT book. 65778, 65779, 65771 and 65785. Please pause video and do it now. assuming you already looked them up in your CBT book and hear what you find. 6577A, placement of amniotic membranes on the ocular surface without suture. 65779, this is an identical, so it includes all the information from the cover bulb. 65778, which is the pericope, except 65778 is done with suture. 65771, radio keratotomy. And 65785, implantation of intrastromal corneal ring segments. Follow my tips and strategy. You highlight the main difference between each CBT code, and when you're done, then you should have an idea what your focus should be when you read the procedure report. Let's read it. A 15-year-old male presents with progressive loss of vision, severe pain, tearing in the right eye after being trapped accidentally by her cat. Examination revealed severe ocular inflammation and a large corneal epithelial defect. Decision was made to place an amniotic membrane in the eye. After application of topical anesthetic, the amniotic membrane is inserted into the conjunctival fornix and enter over the corneal surface. Suture are used to secure placement. What procedure or diagnosis code should be reported? Based on what I just highlighted, a decision was made to place an amniotic membrane in the eye, and suture are used to secure the amniotic membranes in place. So, 65779 is the right code to use for this procedure. That said, the correct answer of this case is B. 65779 S0501XA W5503XA. Now you understand my backward approach. I only look up the first set of procedure code, and I already know the answer. I don't even have to look at the diagnosis code, S code for injury, and W code for external cause. I believe in this case, S0501XA is for the right cornea operation, and W5503XA is for accidental strap by cat. I hope that you have learned something new and valuable for coding today. That is all for now. Thank you so much for watching, for liking, and sharing this video. If you find this video helpful, informative, and easy to learn with this format, or if you have any suggestion, then please leave me a comment below just to let me know. I really appreciate it. Also, the more positive comments that you leave for me, the better chance for my videos will be reviewed by other people. So please continue to do so. Until next time, have a great day.